Namaste students, in last class we had read the poem. Now let me explain the poem in my own words. Listen carefully. Once there was a king who was ill for many days. He had rosy cheeks, eyes were clear and bright, and had good appetite. He was also having a good night's sleep too, but he was very sick. He was checked by many doctors, but all in vain. They could not recognize the disease that the king was suffering from. And as a result, king got angry with them. So he ordered to cut off their heads right there and now. Then again, he used to send for more doctors from medical schools. One day, two doctors came to diagnose him. One of them was as poor as rat and the other was filthy rich. The poor one was very bookish, and for being studious, he never had time to grow fat. The rich one had never looked into a book. The rich one's patients never troubled him. They paid him well if they recovered, or if they died, their left-hand family used to pay him more. So the poor doctor diagnosed the king as sound as a nut. The king decreed to hang him up. The other doctor, the rich one, got thoughtful of the situation and then said that the king could get well if he sleeps in a shirt of a happy man for one night. So the king ordered his ministers to bring the shirt of happiest man in the kingdom. The soldiers rode to every end of the kingdom, but to no avail. They met many, but none of them were happy. They found poor men who want to be rich, and the rich who want to be more rich. Men wore tight clothes to suppress their fat upper body, while women wore so for their lower body. But the outcome did not make them happy. At last, they found a man at the village gate, rolling on the grass, whistling, singing, and laughing. The tired soldiers asked the man if he was happy. The man replied affirmative. He said, being idle, he has so much to do that he does not get time to be unhappy. At last, they found a man who was genuinely happy. They immediately asked for a shirt. This request made the man to laugh and roll more. He said he would have given them the shirt without much ado, but he had none on his back. The king was reported of all the unsuccessful spies. Along with that also, he was reported about his subjects' sorrows, daily sorrows, how the subjects were striving to survive. His subjects' survival made him ashamed of his useless life. At that moment, the king understood that he had the luxury to feel sick even though he was not affected. Somehow, people's distresses made him realize his uselessness. Something ticked inside him and made him shrug away his abstract sickness and donned on the kingly responsibilities. The king laid his windows open and set his spirit free. From then onwards, he became worthy to his title. The king started to take care of his subjects, and in return he got blessed, which gave him a healthy and joyous life to live. This poem highlights the necessity of social mingling. It also highlights that happiness cannot be found in material things, but it can be found in worthy, fruitful work. I hope you have understood this simple poem, but with an important message or lesson to follow in life. So students, we come to the end of this class. Wait for the next class for question answers. Till then students, Namah Shivaya.